30 to 40 years is the peak age where people develop psoriatic arthritis, which is about a decade later than the peak age for psoriasis, for the skin disease. People usually take 10 to 20 years to develop psoriatic arthritis. In terms of the disease course, it's rather unpredictable. People will experience episodes of worsening of the psoriatic arthritis and then episodes of improvement. Early symptoms with psoriatic arthritis are important. For example, in the Toronto cohort, it was shown that people who developed psoriatic arthritis the year before they were diagnosed had reported joint pain, fatigue, and stiffness. So again, these symptoms, although they may seem non-specific, are very important, and maybe the initial steps that patients experience even before they are diagnosed. Psoriasis is a relatively common skin disease. The form that is most associated with psoriatic arthritis is psoriasis that's located on the scalp. Having psoriasis behind the ear or inside the ear also counts. Perianal psoriasis. And then, of course, there's the more frequent form where classic psoriasis is localized on the knees and on the elbows. It's very bothersome for patients, and there's degrees of this. And then the most classic form is what we call plaque psoriasis, where people will develop these raised lesions. Well, there's a rash that's called guttated psoriasis, which looks like little drops of rain. That's how it got its name. And it's just very little patches of rash, but it's spread over almost the entire body. So if you add these patches together, it's a lot. It's just they're spread all over. And people tend to get this more often after a strep throat, and it's most common in young people. So that's one form in addition to the classic plaque psoriasis. There's one that's called inverse psoriasis, where people tend to develop the rash in the skin folds, and it tends to look different just because the skin in those areas has a different quality. It's not going to scale as much, but it's going to be red, and it's going to hurt, and it's going to ooze fluid, and it's very uncomfortable. And then there are more rare forms. About 2 to 4% of people with psoriasis will have a rash that's called pustular psoriasis, and it looks like little pimples on the hands or on the soles of the feet. And of course, these are again itchy and tender. And these pimples are sterile. There's no bacteria in it, so it's not a real pimple. It's just an inflammation, but it looks like that. And we see this in people with psoriatic arthritis as well. And then, of course, there's more severe systemic forms where most of the skin, 80% to 90% of the skin, is affected with red rash. We call that erythroderma. And when that is severe, that sometimes needs hospitalization and treatment with potent drugs to try to get the skin under control. Because if you think the skin is our largest organ and it's essential for the body to function properly and to be protected from everything that's around it. Male psoriasis can look in many different ways, but the most common form is what we call nail pitting. There are small pits on the surface of the nail, and again, that can have different degrees of severity, from just a few pits on several nails to a really old and the entire nail surface being changed by that. And then the extreme form of pitting would be nail plate crumbling, where the nail can turn into a powder and then it's basically just disintegrating. Another form is what we call Annika Lysis, when the nail lifts off the nail bed. The nails grow slowly. So even with treatment, it takes months for the nail to fully recover, but it's definitely reversible with effective treatment.